Hello everyone, welcome back. I hope you're all doing great today. With so many trending viral products doing the rounds on our social feeds, it can be hard to tell the good from the bad, but I couldn't resist trying this one. It's a Korean brand called Tear Tear. Yeah, Tear Tear. I got 5 products from them directly from Korea to make sure that what I'm getting are really legit, authentic. So this is not a sponsored video. I just want to find out if they really are worth the hype and great for mature skin as well. Ta-da! I got 3 pieces of Tear Tear Mask Fit Red Cushion Foundations in different shades. This one is 23 and sand. And this one is 24W soft beige, while the last one, 24N latte. They are all in 18 grams. I ended up buying 3 pieces because I'm not really sure what shade matches or suits my complexion. And I've heard that this oxidizes. Maybe I'm gonna give away 1 piece and the other one for my daughter. So hopefully I will get 1. Comment below if you're interested in joining. Type mine and don't forget to like, subscribe, and share this video. So now I'm gonna swatch them out and see what shade is right for me. This is not a try on and wear test video because I'm currently wearing makeup, but I will do that in another review soon. There are so many good reviews about these cushion foundations. They're all over TikTok, YouTube. I'm actually last on the bandwagon. The texture is wet. I don't mind it. It has full coverage and a little bit does go a long way, I suppose. It perfectly conceals blemishes and redness, blurs imperfections and texture for airbrush skin. It also claims about longevity that it lasts up to 72 hours, fix in place. Wow, that's amazing. I hope it applies to someone who lives in a tropical country like me as well. It's supposed to be sweat proof, transfer proof, and has a non-creasing formula. I'm super excited to try this cushion foundation and share with you my experience as well. And because of this Tear Tear cushion foundation, of course, I had to buy their popular and most talked about toner, the Tear Tear Milk Skin, for a complete experience.
So I'm gonna show you what it looks like. Of course.
All the skincare products I use on my face are from La Mer, but I also want to try this toner because I've been reading great reviews about it. Its key benefits for achieving glass skin. Korean beauty has been popular for almost a decade now, making glass skin sought after goal among skincare buffs, so why not try it? This is a good product for prepping the skin before applying the Tea Tree Cushion Foundation, and they likely complement each other well. This one, based on their website, is fantastic because although it applies like a toner, it feels very nourishing and hydrating like an emulsion or serum. It intensely moisturizes your skin, effectively combating dryness and fatigue. All this delivering unparalleled soothing sensation for that coveted glass skin look. It has 2% niacinamide, chamomile or chamomile, don't know how to pronounce that, rice bran extract, ceramide, water, glycerin. It's also alcohol-free. This claims deep moisturizing and instant glow, as well as fills the skin for up to 24 hours. So after applying Tear Tear Milk Skin Toner, it is advised to apply the Tear Tear Ceramic Milk Ampoule for long-lasting glow effect. I love the bottle. It's really luxurious looking, but I cannot open it. There you go. This one is for long lasting glow effect. It enhances skin's elasticity and deep moisturization. Oh wow. So the key ingredients of the ceramic ampoules are vegan milk complex, 6 ceramide complex, fermentation extracts, and many more. It's for all skin types, sensitive and dry. Same as the milk toner, the milk ampoules' key benefit is instant glass skin. Who doesn't want that? Not me. Let's see. Actually, I was about to begin using retinol to become part of my skincare routine. I've never tried using retinol or retina or whatever before. I should have started a long time ago, but my allergologist prevented me from trying it because I had a very sensitive skin. However, after a long period of desensitization and allergy treatments, I feel that I am ready for it, doing a bit better now, and I want to give it a try because I'm not getting any younger, you know. I'm starting to have fine lines on my forehead, as well as some wrinkles. I am not a dermatologist or an expert, but based on my research, retinol increases skin cell production or collagen. It can reduce these issues and more, giving your skin a fresher, plumper appearance over time and with proper use. I have so many retinol products here, and if you're interested, let me just show you quickly. This one is CeraVe or CeraVe Resurfacing Retinol Serum. The Neutrogena Fragrance-Free Rapid Wrinkle Repair. It's a retinol regenerating cream. This one is the Avène Retinol for the eyes. I don't know how to show you this because of the light. And this one is the L'Oreal Paris Age Perfect Cell Renewal Anti-Aging Cream. This one is the Ordinary Retinol 1% in Squalene. The Verst Pressed Restart Gentle Retinol Body Lotion. Of course, I have a CeraVe or CeraVe Hydrating Mineral Sunscreen Broad Spectrum SPF 50. It's for the face. Oh, one more thing. I got Aquaphor. This one is a lip balm, immediate relief for very dry lips. I feel I can integrate retinol with this Tear Tear skincare products as well. I'm going to use retinol anyway once a week for the first month and then increase the amount gradually until I get used to them. So let me know your thoughts and experiences about the Tear Tear products I've shown you today. Have you ever tried them, especially the Tear Tear Cushion Foundation and the retinol? Do you also use them? What brands do you use? That's about it for today. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you've enjoyed. If you did, please give me a thumbs up. And remember our giveaway. I'll see you next time. Bye.